I wanted to be a marine biologist since I was a little kid. I didn't necessarily know what that meant, but it's something I always wanted to do. I work in the deep sea. I'm most interested in deep sea corals that live well below where light can penetrate the oceans. When the spill first occurred, our first thoughts were kind of like everybody else, that oil floats. And we really didn't think we were gonna see the big impact in the deep sea that we did. There were these corals that were literally covered in oil. The oil went up to the surface, they applied dispersant to it, but some of those chemicals in the dispersant turn out to be toxic to biology. These are corals that are hundreds of years old that are gonna take at least decades to recover. Some of them won't recover at all. The deep sea and some of these habitats that we work on in the lab are really significant to the productivity of the oceans. The nutrients that feed these communities, the plankton in shallow water that then feed the fish, that then feed us, are reliant on the nutrients that come from the deep sea. Moving into restoration and what you can do to actually put them back together again and try and recover some of the ecosystem function that the deep sea corals have that we know is tied into the rest of the wider Gulf ecosystem. And that's going to be really interesting work. It's going to be something I'm doing for the rest of my career. I think it's really important that these students get a chance to do these things, not just read about them. It's much more powerful when students realize that they're the scientists. They're the ones who can do this. Being a part of something that you know is happening for the first time is really why I started studying the deep sea. We're doing something that people are going to look back on for a long time.